Well, hello, Faith family, and thank you for joining us again for the Daily Connection. We'd love to get in the Word, and we hope to ultimately have the Word to get into us. So today we're looking at Philippians chapter 4, verse 18, continuing in this thought pattern of finding all of our sufficiency in Christ. And we see Paul giving a huge commendation, if you will, to the church at Philippi for the gift they provided. Look with me in verse 18. But I have received everything in full. I have an abundance. I am fully supplied, having received from Epaphroditus what you provided, a fragrant aroma, an acceptable sacrifice, pleasing to God. And so here we see Paul, after talking about the gift that came and the fact that, hey, I'm not just focused on the gift, I'm focused on how you benefit from the gift, saying that the gift that you gave to me, it wasn't just sufficient. It didn't just satisfy my need. It surpassed it all. And he does that with basically three terms that he kind of lumps together as if to say, hey, if you don't understand it from this term, understand it through this term. And, you know, we can break those down and it's not really that complicated. You know, first of all, he says, I received everything in full. And that was a commercial term in secular Greek that usually meant that someone had received a receipt indicating that they had completely honored their debt. It was done. And so Paul says, anything I was lacking, hey, you completely satisfied that. You've taken care of every bit of that. You know, and just in case there was any doubt, he says, I have an abundance. And the idea of overflowing, meaning that whatever need was there, you know, if you think about a container, you know, you fill that container to the very top, it's full, but if you continue to pour into that container, it'll begin to flow out. Paul says, hey, now it's flowing out. You've given so much. And then lastly, I am fully supplied, meaning there's no lack. There's no need left on his part in terms of what will sustain him in gospel ministry. And then he does this, and I love this because he frames this in a sense that is not duty-driven. It's very much delight-driven. It's very much a delightful opportunity, and I think it's important. Because a lot of times when we talk about giving, sadly, we will frame it in the context, and I say we, I'm talking about, you know, pastors in some instances, sometimes our material that we study through, even, you know, sometimes our teachers will present giving in terms of a duty that we are expected to carry out, it's a responsibility, but yet we really need to see it more in terms of the delight that we draw from it and that we then give back to God, because that's what Paul's saying here. He says, this gift is a fragrant offering, an acceptable sacrifice pleasing to God. So here we have a Jew, Paul, drawing on the Levitical system, the Levitical sacrificial system, to show these believers in Philippi that what you're doing is not just meeting my need. That's just the surface level issue. What you're really doing is offering up to God a pleasing sacrifice. And that's something that several New Testament writers do on a regular basis. For instance, Paul himself, if we go back to Romans chapter 12, verse 1, he says, you know, therefore. And of course, we know the word therefore is leading back to chapters 11, all the way back to chapter 1. You know, this big, extensive treatment of theology in which Paul basically explains that God has provided his salvation and saved your soul through the activity of Christ. Paul says, hey, based on that, based on the fact that you've now received that salvation, he says, brothers and sisters, in view of the mercy of God, I urge you, present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is true worship. So we see that this idea of offering our bodies as a sacrifice, meaning that our life now is not lived for us, it's lived for Christ, it's lived for the honor of God, is framed within the context of a sacrifice, that same Levitical system idea. You know, another one comes to us in Hebrews chapter 13, starting in verse 15. And I know we don't have time to talk through all of these extensively today, but I do right now, but I'd encourage you to take some time later to do that. The writer of Hebrews says this, therefore, through him, let us continually offer up to God a sacrifice of praise. That is, the fruit of lips that confess his name. Don't neglect to do what is good and to share, for God is pleased with such sacrifices. So, you know, in one sense, he could be talking about worship when he says the sacrifice of praise. He says the fruit of lips. And then that could also mean just the words that we speak. That when we speak what is good and wholesome and what edifies and builds up. And of course, we know also, he says that do what is good. You know, all of that frame within that idea of, you know, a sacrificial system, and meaning that what we're doing, we're not doing purely out of a sense of duty. We're doing it out of a sense of delight. First of all, the delight that we have in Christ, and then ultimately the delight that we get, you know, our Father takes whenever we give and we honor, we sacrifice, we serve, we love, all those things. It's a pleasing aroma to Him. And so I really want us to be, I hope we're challenged in this today. And hopefully it'll draw us away from the idea of giving as a sense of duty. Because typically when we do it that way, we're focused on a number, we're focused on a percentage, things of that nature. But when we give out of a sense of delight in God, it means, and I go back to the original topic here, all sufficient in Christ, it means that I'm giving not out of a sense of a duty to God and as a sense of repayment to God, because obviously we can't do that. I'm doing it out of an overflow of the delight I have in Christ, because He has saved me, because His Holy Spirit is now sanctifying me. I find great delight in that, and He is my all sufficiency. So I don't need things. I don't need stuff. All these other things that preoccupied me in my pre-Christ existence, now they don't. Now they're just a means to praising God in my present Christ existence. And so I really want us to be challenged today, because one of the questions that the writer presents is this: how does your life produce a fragrant aroma that's pleasing to God? Well, if we look at this text, we know that one way that is by giving sacrificially to sustain gospel ministry. And we do that. We do that through giving to the general fund, whereby we take it and through our budget, we break that down into various portions to, you know, to be active on the global scene, not just in terms of the International Mission Board, but also in terms of our own missionaries that have launched through us. We do that on a country scene, or, you know, a continent scene, if you will, through the North American Mission Board, by supporting church planting, by supporting church health, things of that nature. We do that on a state level. There's all the ways it breaks down, but it comes back originally to each one of us, born again children of God, giving sacrificially out of love, out of delight, not duty, knowing that what we're doing will be a pleasing aroma. It will be a pleasing sacrifice. It'll be a fragrant aroma, a pleasing sacrifice. And so I challenge you today to reflect on your pattern of giving. I challenge you today to reflect on your stewardship. And that's what we're talking about here, stewardship. And ask yourself the question, does my stewardship reflect that Jesus is my all and my everything? And does my stewardship demonstrate a sense of delight in who God is and what God is doing, so that when I give, whether it's time, talent, or money, God receives it as it's a fragrant aroma to Him, it is a pleasing sacrifice to Him. Well, hope you're having a great week, friends. You're almost there. I know you've had Friday marked on the calendar, but don't let that be your obsession. Instead, find your delight in Christ. Find your determination and to praise Him today in whatever way He provides for you to do that. And as always, one of the ways that we know He does that is by us heading out the door living sent.